Hey, indie artists, if you're looking for a way to build awareness for your music and make a little money as well, then proactive music placements is for you. Bobby Borg here, your music business coach, with short, no BS advice that can help you turn your passion for music into a more successful business. Over the last 30 years, I've drummed in major label bands, signed to Atlantic, wrote several music business books published by Billboard, and taught at major universities like USC Thornton. I recently spoke with independent DJ producer Skydancer C3R in England about sync music licensing. Here's her question, and here's my answer.
What methods do you suggest for independent artists who want to get into sync licensing?
Well, you could always shoot for getting a major music publishing deal, which is what most independent artists want to do, but that's probably not the most practical method when first starting out. So you want to focus more on proactive placement methods. And actually, I've got a list of a couple, so let's go through them. So the first thing would be actually local businesses. So this is crazy. When I was going to Berklee College of Music in Boston, there was a liquor store called Circle Liquor Stores in Kenmore Square that was family owned and advertised on the radio. So I thought, hey, why don't I actually write a jingle, go directly to the owner and pitch it to them? And wouldn't you know it, they actually ended up using it on their next radio advertisement. So boom, there goes a great example of, you know, of proactivity. The second one would be networking at film festivals. So where do directors go? They go to film festivals. So it makes sense to hang out there and see what happens. So there was this group that I was mentoring once called Mayfair, and they actually went to the Sundance Film Festival. They didn't even have passes to go there. And they hung out in the lobby of the hotels where people like go afterwards to party and drink. And they were just jamming acoustically. And someone asked them if they want to play at a party in the upstairs hotel suite. And they did. And there was a director there. And long story short, they ended up in a major motion picture film. So boom, there you go again about being proactive. The third one, this is a crazy story, is hitting up spin teachers at gyms. So true story, there was a songwriter that actually pitched his music to spin teachers at spin classes. And just crazy, there was actually the wife of a music publishing company owner at the gym, heard the song, liked it, told her husband about it. The husband ended up signing this artist to a publishing deal. Crazy story, right? But again, an example of proactivity. In another case, oh, this is crazy, hitting up YouTube influencers. So I have a student at Thornton School of Music that had a great idea. He was a pop artist. So he hit up a makeup artist on YouTube that has one of those huge channels that gets millions of hits and hundreds of thousands of views per video. And he just said, would you be interested in putting like my music on the bed of like one of your next, you know, tutorials? And they had an agreement and she did that. And literally this led to hundreds of thousands of streams, and he reached his 1 million mark on streams on Spotify. I mean, that's again, another example of proactivity. Another thing that you can do is utilize placement services. So there's placement services like Taxi Music. And what Taxi Music does is for a small fee, they'll send you out listings of big companies that are looking for music and film, television, video games, you know, documentary films, etc. And if you fit the bill and you send it over to Taxi, your screener will listen to it. If they like it, they actually forward you over to the company, and then you negotiate with them directly. And I have literally seen artists make a good living using services like Taxi. And I even saw one artist get signed to a major deal and end up going gold as well. So again, about being proactive and not waiting around for people. And then the last thing that's really available to a lot of people is college films. I mean, there's a college in every city, right, around the world, essentially. And those colleges oftentimes have film departments. And in the film departments, you have students that are working on projects that need music for their projects, right? So you hit up actually some of the students, the professor of the class, of course, which is quite experienced, is going to hear it. That actually might go on to getting into a film festival, potentially, where it could get heard by other people. And then who knows, that director of the film could graduate and end up 5 or 10 years from now being the next actual big director. And you guys have this relationship when he was coming up. So, you know, these are all, again, very, very proactive methods and things that you want to focus on first and foremost to build your credibility, because all of these things are going to help you when you actually do pitch a major music publishing company. So always remember, you want to go for proactive placement ideas first.
If you want to learn more about how you can turn your passion for music into a more successful business, be sure to check out this video or the video linked in the description below.